let's stand in solidarity and cast a light for each other and have each other's back, whether we be Tibetan, Uyghur, Chinese, or Canadian.
Tenth March 1959, people of Tibet revolted against China's illegal occupation of sovereign Tibet. With their fist in the air, Tibetans flooded the streets of Lhasa shouting, "Bhögidakbu Bhumiin." Tibet belongs to Tibet.
The latest being 24-year-old Yongpen from Gamba Meruma Township, who passed away after self-immolating on 26 November.
His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama of Tibet described 10 March 1959 as the day destined to be the most momentous Lhasa had ever seen,
displacing the Tibetan language as the medium of instruction. Children in Nangchen had been banned from attending Tibetan language classes in monastery to celebrate His Holiness' legacy and his four commitments. Those of us who live in freedom has the responsibility. All the Tibetans would like to thank Nancy Pelosi, the Speaker of the House of Representatives, co-sponsor Representative James Patrick McGover, Representative Christopher Henry Smith.
He was the leader of the Green Party of Canada. And a longtime friend of Tibet. And then I married my handsome Tibetan husband, T.C. Tetong, who is probably, and you'll have to correct me if I'm wrong, the only person here today who grew up in a free Tibet.
These millions of Uyghurs who are detained without trial are forced to endure brainwashing, torture, and other inhumane treatments. And that's to independence. Independence for East Turkestan and independence for Tibet.
Tibetans took the streets of Lhasa, Tibet's capital, rising up against Chinese illegal invasion and occupations of their homeland. They surrounded the Potala Palace, the home of the Dalai Lama, to protect his life and the future of Tibet.
On 61st anniversary of Tibetan National Uprising Day, all of us 61 years ago grows stronger every day than Tibet to continue to subject it, and the fact that the of Tibet, and finally we pray the utmost preventness that His Holiness the Dalai Lama may live a long life. I would like to request Richard Yukogla to lead the long life prayer.
Free Tibet!
Free Tibet!
Free Tibet!